Okay.
New job, new apartment. Everything's coming up, Ryan. You hear that, Ryan? Everything's coming up you. Me, us, okay, whatever. It's all going our way, right? You got the call. Mom, Dad, Grandma, Grandpa, everyone is coming to your, my, our, oh, whatever. They're all coming here for the family's favorite holiday. No pressure. Okay, and so is Sammy. This year is going to be our year to finally have the traditional evergreen family romantic Christmas story. Tummy is going to keep it together, okay? We're finally going to tell our lifelong best friend how we feel about her. Okay, so Tummy, I need you to work with me on this. Samatha. Sammy, we've been friends a long time. To be honest, I've always thought of us as more than just friends. We've been partners in life, seeing each other through tough times and celebrating good times, always together. And I want to stay that way, always together. What I'm saying is, I'd like this to be the romantic Christmas story we tell our kids someday. Ooh, okay, and then I give her the massage gift certificate. She swoons, the family cheers, and then wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, happily ever after. Okay, it's going to be fine, it's going to be fine. She's going to feel the same way. We're going to tell our kids about this someday. And, okay, but why risk the incredible friendship we've had for years? Just because I'm stupidly, totally in love with her. Oh my god, this is so dumb. You're right, buddy. You're always right. Let me just light a candle or two. Oh. All right. Woo! Okay, I got a pre-courtesy flush so this whole place doesn't end up smelling like the den of a lactose intolerant T-Rex! Oh my god! What the what? Theme restaurant in my new apartment? There's no theme restaurant. I've gone back in time. Holy crap. Okay. All right. Whoa. Okay, pterodactyl. All right. Okay, Ryan, I'm not sure how you got to the Cretaceous, but you've got to get Jurassic out of here. Pronto. I had to figure out how me and my toilet got here so we can get home. My toilet. The pre-courtesy flag. Holy crap! I have a time-traveling toilet. Okay. I gotta call Sammy. Sammy, hey, can you come over a little early? I have something really important to tell you.
Merry Christmas, Rhino! Ready for your big day? Hosting your first evergreen family Christmas party. Your tummy must be a mess with stress.
Well, aren't you quite the poetess?
I just mean, you're gonna do great.
Thanks. Hey, there's something
Ryan, may I go first?
Why did you call me Ryan? You never use my actual name.
Because, Ryan, what I have to say is important, and I want this to be perfect. I want you to open your gift now, while it's just the two of us.
Oh, sure, but,
Ryan,
I just...
open it.
Oh, it's a picture. Did you draw this?
Yep.
Yeah, it's great. Wait, is that us as kids?
Yep. Oh. And little me is giving little you a flower. It's a daisy, and you're kissing me on the cheek, and... both the little S's look super happy because, well, we're in love, and...
I see that. It's great.
Rhino, really? This is the most romantic holiday in your family, and I give you a picture of the kid versions of us in love for Christmas because...
Oh.
Yep.
Ooh.
Beat you to it, huh? Bet you didn't see this coming. Me telling you how I feel before you can drop your romantic Christmas present on me.
Nope. I specifically did not see this coming.
You're not off the hook, Rhino. You still have to hit me with the Evergreen Family Christmas magic if you're gonna tell our kids about this someday.
Yeah,
Ooh,
my stomach is a...
Oh, classic Rhino. Whenever anyone asks where you are, the answer is always, in the bathroom. I had to explain to your landlord that you weren't using drugs when you locked yourself in there during the showing. I understand your tummy troubles after the love of your life, like, declares her feelings for you, but... Wait, I am the love of your life, right?
Yes, totally. I just... Oh, ah, tummy. Ooh, this guy. Just give me a sec, and I'll be right back.
We'll leave this part out when we tell the story, okay?
Oh, God, what do I do? What do I do? All I got her was a gift certificate. I've blown this whole thing. If only I could go back in time into... Wait a minute. The time toilet? I'll go to the past and buy a better gift for Sammy. Wait, but how do you control it? I was sitting here, and I said something about a T-Rex, and swoosh. Then when's a good time to catch myself alone before I bought the gift certificate? Yes, when I pooped in this bathroom the day I first looked at the apartment. Yes, perfect. 6 weeks ago, on Wednesday, in this very bathroom. Potpourri? No candles? No Christmas music? Perfect! It worked!
And the bathroom is right in here.
Oh God, oh God.
The door sticks sometimes, so just give it a minute.
Alright, here you go. I'll just show your girlfriend around the rest of the place while you...
Sorry, we had burritos for lunch and I'm... Oh, and she isn't my girlfriend. I mean, she's a friend and a girl. Well, if we're being honest, I
Hey,
just...
whoa, TMI.
Yeah, sure.
The seal needs to be fixed, so don't flush it while you're on it or it'll leak. I'll see to that before you move in.
You know, it's good advice. The toilet, it's a time machine. Shh! What the? Keep it down. Sammy and Kincaid will hear. Who's Kincaid? The landlord.
Oh...
And who are you? I'm you. 6 weeks from now. Oh, Christmas Eve me. Yep. You're hosting the Evergreen Family Christmas party.
I am?
Oh. Oh, that makes my tummy hurt more than the burritos. Well, strap in. Because I'm about to get your tummy all sorts of worked up. Yeah. So Sammy's going to tell you that she's in love with you. Us?
Really?
Yep. And she gives us a really awesome gift.
Oh, what is it?
I can't tell you. You need to be surprised. Our gift, on the other hand. You mean the gift certificate to that massage place she loves? Yeah, it's not going to cut the proverbial mustard. So I used the time toilet to come back and get you to get a better gift than that. So, so you don't look stupid. Oh, how about an engagement ring? Okay, that might be too much. Like, something romantic, but not frighteningly so.
I think the ring is a pretty good play.
Okay, look, we don't want to look desperate, man, okay? We need something cute and sweet and thoughtful and romantic.
Like what?
What do you mean, like what? I should have realized that if you don't have any ideas, then you, I, whoever, we're screwed.
Wait, you have a time machine, yeah?
I have a time toilet, yeah?
Are we calling it that?
I'm older than you, so I know better.
All right, fine. Use the time toilet to go back and see some of those romantic Christmases that Mom and Dad or Grandma and Grandpa always used to talk about.
Damn, I am really clever, aren't I?
I mean, well, you were.
Hey, you okay in there, Rhino?
Be right out!
No need to yell.
I gotta go, so you do whatever you need to skedaddle through time and leave me to my business. Oh, and I still think you should buy the ring.
Well, good thing I'm in charge then. Oh! And, Ryan, there's toilet paper under the sink to save you the panic. Potpourri? Candles? What? Christmas music. I'm back. Okay. Who do I go see first? Mom and Dad? No. Grandma and Grandpa. Oh, Uncle Jude always brags about how great his romantic Christmas with Aunt Chrissy was, but he's also an unreliable dirtbag.
Hey, you okay in there? Rhino? My declaration of love didn't scare you that bad, did it?
No! Of course not! I just, need a few more minutes.
You've already been in there for 15 minutes. I'm used to your tummy troubles, but...
I'm sorry. All the stress from hosting and the new place, and now you and me...
I didn't think it would be stressful.
No! I mean, there's a lot of other stress, and it's, stressful. I'm having trouble enjoying the whole, you and me thing.
Rhino, Christmas is your family's favorite holiday. They love you, and they love me. Even if the tree falls over and bursts into flames, it's gonna be good, because this is a romantic evergreen Christmas.
Sammy, you know me. I'm a worrier with a touchy tummy, and so I just need a little while longer to...
Rhino, we've been friends since we were 3 years old. You've been in the bathroom for a significant amount of that time, even right now, and that's fine. You've got your tummy thing, like I've got my super long second toe thing, but... You've always come out of the bathroom feeling better. Always. So, I don't know, today of all days, you're still in there and you don't sound any better. And all I can think is the difference between today and every other day is I told you that I'm in love with you and that I want this to be our romantic Christmas story. You don't want that, do you?
No, I just need to flush the toilet real quick. And then...
You just need to flush the toilet real quick? That's the worst excuse you've ever used. I thought you felt the same way about me. Merry Christmas, Rhino. I'll leave the picture in the hall here.
I guess I... can go back 3 minutes, knock myself out cold, and try to fix what just happened. Or I could just give her the stupid gift certificate and apologize for such a dumb gift. Where is the gift certificate? Don't worry. I put it down here on the counter, right where this mysterious tiny box is. Holy crap. You did it. I did it. I went out and bought a ring? I can't give her a ring yet, can I? It might patch things up. Oh, but it might just make things even worse. Oh, none of it'll even matter if I don't stop her from leaving. Sammy, wait! Oh, thank God, you're still here.
Yeah, well, I can't storm off into a storm. Backed myself into a corner there.
I mean, you could have said blizzard.
Are you trying to make things better?
Sorry, I was just trying to help. Look, anyway, I'm sorry I was in the bathroom for so long. The truth is, I just want this to be perfect too, Sammy. It has to be perfect. Something that I've wanted for this long. Something that I've waited so long to tell you how I feel, Sammy. And if it isn't perfect, if I don't knock it out the park, then I waited for no real reason, right? And your gift was so thoughtful and sweet and meaningful, and mine... I was so focused on telling you that I sort of didn't think enough about showing you. But I think I figured out the best way to show... you. Pretty good first kiss, huh?
That was... yeah. But it wasn't our first kiss.
But yes, it was. I would remember if...
4th of July, 2004.
I was unconscious, Sammy.
And I saved your life. But not before I slipped you a little tongue.
You what?
I just wanted to see what it would be like. So what is the gift that kept you hiding in the bathroom,
Oh, actually, I'd like to wait until everyone's here. It'll be more of a romantic evergreen Christmas story that way.
Fine, I get it. But maybe I could get another little stocking stuffer to tide me over. Merry Christmas, Ryan.
Merry Christmas, Samantha. I left some candles burning in the bathroom, so I'm going to stop them from burning my new place down, but would you mind pulling all the hors d'oeuvre platters from the fridge, and I'll be there in a sec.
Sure. Don't take too much time in there, though.
I have all the time I need in here, and I'm going to use it to find you the perfect romantic Christmas present. I promise.
I Cuties, we have even more rom-coms for you on our new show, When I Met You. Love can be funny, weird, awkward, happy, or all of the above. When I Met You takes true love stories and transforms them into short romantic comedies. Every Monday, listen to a new When I Met You to see love's peculiar knack for being both deeply personal and hugely universal. Follow When I Met You on your favorite podcast app to get the episodes as soon as they drop.